Hi folks, hope you're okay today. It's good to be with you. The reason why we're out here today is we're trying to share the grace and the love of God to you today. That God's grace is abounding, is great, glorious, majestic. It says, seek the Lord while he may be found, call upon him while if we seek the Lord, and if we cry out to him and say, Lord, I need you, Lord, forgive me, then the Lord will forgive us. The Lord will show us mercy. Call upon him while he is near. That if we call upon him, if we cry out to him, he is near. And he knows where we are at. He knows our pain, he knows our problem, he knows what we need. Seek the Lord while he may be found, call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him return to his Lord, and he will have mercy on him. And to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For he will abundantly pardon. No matter how much you have done wrong, no matter how much you have failed, no matter how much you have messed up, no matter how much you have failed, no matter how much you have let yourself down, let your family down, or let God down, says in the Bible, he will abundantly pardon. He will abundantly pardon. No matter how much mistake you have made, no matter how big a mistake you have made, he will abundantly pardon. He will wash you as white as snow. He will wash you as clean as snow. No matter how much you have failed, no matter how much you have let God down, he will abundantly pardon, and God will forgive you if you cry out to him. If you cry out to him, he will forgive you.
Good morning.
Good afternoon. He will abundantly pardon. He will abundantly pardon. Abundantly pardon. No matter how much you fail, no matter how much you let God down, no matter what you have done, if you cry out to God, if you cry out to God, he will forgive you. He will cleanse you. He will show you his mercy. He will show you his love. He will abundantly pardon. My friends, if you want to know God, if you want to know whether you're right with God, if you want to be right with God, then know that he will abundantly pardon because he died on that cross. He died on that cross for you. And he suffered and died on that cross, nailed to that cross, shedding his blood upon that cross, and nailed to that cross. He shed his blood on that cross that you may live. He shed his blood on that cross that he may abundantly pardon you. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thought. Let the wicked forsake his way. We gotta go away from that which is not good. We've got to forsake his way. We've got to forsake the way. And if we forsake the way and we go to him, he's merciful and kind, and he will abundantly pardon. He is kind and loving, and he will forgive, and he will show you love and mercy. He says, I will abundantly pardon, and he will forgive you. But you've got to forsake the way. You've got to forsake it. You've got to forsake it. You've got to forsake it. And turn away from that which is wrong and say, Lord, have mercy. And he'll abundantly pardon. He'll abundantly pardon and forgive you because he died for you.
I'm still not going to come back.
He didn't go.
He will abundantly pardon. He will abundantly pardon. And all, he came and died. And all that he showed you love. All that he showed you is love. He showed you his love at the cross. He showed you his love when he died on that cross and shed his blood on that cross and took the wrath and the judgment for you. He will abundantly pardon. Oh, my friends, the love of God. The love of God that Christ would die on that cross that you may be forgiven. And you say, God, I don't want it. I don't want him. And you're pushing away God, who is coming and saying, come, come and drink of my eternal life. Drink of my love. Drink of my son. Drink of my salvation. He will abundantly pardon. He will abundantly pardon. The wrath of God is upon us. The Lord is near to those who have a broken heart and save such as a contrite heart. He loves it when you come with a broken heart. But if you are proud and having sex outside of marriage, then you're proud. God hates pride. But if you come broken in your heart and say, God, have God will forgive you. He will abundantly pardon. But if you're proud in your heart, and you're proud of what you're doing wrong, and proud of your lies, and proud of it, you're bold about what you do wrong, and you're brash about what you do wrong, God hates pride. For God loves it when you're broken. God loves it when you cry to him and you cry and say, Lord, have mercy. He will forgive you. He will cleanse you if you humble yourself before him. He will forgive you if you humble yourself before him. God loves a humble heart. A humble heart that is broken for your sin. Broken, broken for your lies. Broken for your sex. Broken for your drugs. Broken. If you come broken in your heart and cry out to God, then he will forgive you. But if you are proud, if you are arrogant, if you boast in your sin and lies, then God will judge. God hates pride. He hates pride. He hates it when you boast about what you did wrong. But if you come in a humble heart, before God. And if you cry out to God, then God will show you mercy. God will show you love. He will show you His mercy. He will show you His love and grace. And you come to Him and trust Him as your Lord and Savior. Oh, come! Come and drink of God! Drink of Christ! And know His love in your life! Come and drink of God! Come and know His love in your life! Know the joy of the Lord! And the love of God in your life. There's no love in porn, no love in drugs, no love in swearing with any drug, but all there's love in Jesus. There's love in Jesus. There's love in Jesus. Jesus Christ, Christ with His love and mercy. Come while it is time, before it is too late. Come before it is too late. Come and know His love in your life. Know His love in your life. Know His love in your life. Know the love of God. We confess our sins. He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He will abundantly pardon. He will pardon you. Oh, you might have done wrong. You might have failed. You might have let God down, but if you cry to God, He will pardon you. He will forgive you. He will cleanse you and wash you and show you His mercy. If you cry out to Him, He will pardon you and He will forgive you. He will forgive you. He will cleanse you. He will show you His love and show you His mercy. He will forgive you. But you have to cry out to Him. You have to cry out to God. You have to cry out to Jesus. And when you cry to Jesus, He will forgive you. He will cleanse you as you cry out to Him.
But I know what He wants as well.
Stop longer, why He died for you, sir. He will forgive you. He will cleanse you. He will show you His mercy. For He died for you on that cross.
Yeah,
we're able.
Okay, Paul. Very realistic. Listen, we need to stop listening to me. I'm like Canada. I thought you might be able to do some water.
Oh, thank you, Paul.
Some days.
I'm like Canada.
That's the last one. God bless you, man.
I don't want to push it. His life. Come to Christ. Come and know his
his life for you on that cross. Know that he died. Know that he died for you on that cross. Know that he shed his blood for you. He shed his blood and loved you and gave his life for you on that cross. He loved you. How are you doing, Rob?
All right. God bless you. How's it going? How's it going with the missus?
Buy this thing.
Yeah.
So if you ring me or text me,
on Friday. Tell me when you're free and I can come in and what's your name?
Anna.
Anna, okay. So I'm definitely going to get it for you, Anna, yeah?
Thank you.
All right. God bless you.
I see you.